What's up, guys? Today I'm going to answer the most frequently asked questions about myself, my academics, how I started, my journey in wildlife photography so far, how many trips I do every year, and all those questions that you ask, you would want me to answer so that you can start your journey and you have a clear idea about the path in wildlife photography, especially in India. How did you start your journey in wildlife photography? So initially it was about street photography, as I've told a number of times. I was, I think, in my first year of college when I started photography, when I got a DSLR. For a while I just fiddled with it, thought of learning about the basics. Then I think by second year I did a very basic weekend course just to understand about the fundamentals of a DSLR. I did that, and then for a while I practiced street photography about 1 year or 2 years. At that time, flying birds used to capture my attention a lot, and simultaneously I was also preparing for my LLB. So at that time I used to go early morning to shoot birds and all that. At that time I also used to visit the Delhi Zoo to click a couple of pictures, animals playing and all that. I used to rent a 100-400, I remember, very frequently. At that time it was IS-1. And after that, I went on. I went to a bird sanctuary with my mother, Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. In that bird sanctuary, I came across Ratika ma'am, and she was sitting there with the big lens shooting the birds and everything. And I was pretty impressed by that. So I decided to go to her, talk to her, and ask about how do I start and everything. I went to her and I requested her if she can teach me, if she can maybe take a course and I can join or something. She told me that she was not teaching back then, and she recommended the name of Mr. Sudhir Shivaram and told me to find him and join his courses. I googled about Sudhir sir, googled for a while, found out where Sudhir sir was. But unfortunately, Sudhir sir was having all his workshops in South India, and being a girl in India, parents won't allow to travel alone. So that was one problem. I waited for a while and I realized that he had one workshop in Rajasthan, in Bharatpur itself. And I was pretty sure that maybe to Bharatpur my parents will be fine, because ek bar pehle ja chuke the, to psychologically hota hai ki haan pass mein hai. Aur waise bhi India mein jahan pe aapko flight leni pade, to wo dur ho jata hai. Jahan pe aap gaadi se ja sakte hain, wo automatically pass ho jata hai, chahe distance utna hi ho. So that is one problem. But then again, I saw ke Sudhir sir ka ek workshop hai Rajasthan mein. And I found out and I told him that I would want to join it. Now he told me that the seats were full. I was super disheartened, and I remember I used to message him every second day that sir, ek seat hai to de do, khali jagah hai to dekh lo, main kahin bhi so jaungi, bahar so jaungi, mujhe bas workshop mein aane do and all that. So ultimately, finally, there was this cancellation, and I got his reply. He told me that I can come in that workshop, and I told my father. Of course, he was not very up for it, not very comfortable with it. Initially, it was a discussion, turned into an argument, a little heated argument every day, every now and then, that I would want to go. But he was like, no, you need to prepare for your law. This is not the right time and everything. So I had to put in a lot of fight, and ultimately he decided that, okay, theek hai, jao, but ye last time hai, iske baad dobara aap trip pe nahi jaoge, especially wildlife photography. Rest, you know what happened after that. Arzu ma'am, wildlife photography mein kitna income hota hai? One of the most common questions ke wildlife photography mein earning kaise hota hai, income kitna hota hai, income kab hota hai. देखिए, अगर आप वाइल्डलाइफ फोटोग्राफी स्टार्ट करना चाहते हैं तो मैं फ्रैंकली आपको बताऊंगी कि इनकम को बहुत ज़्यादा ध्यान में मत रखिए, बिकॉज वाइल्डलाइफ फोटोग्राफी में इनकम बहुत लेट है, स्पेशली इंडिया में. असाइनमेंट्स मिलने थोड़े मुश्किल है, डिमांड थोड़ा कम है, वो सब चीज़ें हैं. प्लस इतनी फ्रिक्वेंटली लोग वाइल्ड लाइफ पिक्चर्स खरीदते नहीं हैं, तो सेलिंग से भी ज़्यादा इनकम नहीं है, प्रिंट सेलिंग से. ज़्यादातर जो फोटोग्राफर्स हैं, वाइल्ड लाइफ फोटोग्राफर्स हैं, वो अर्न करते हैं अपना बिजनेस एक्सपैंड करके, टीचिंग में जाकर, टूर्स लेकर, या फिर ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज बनाकर. ये तरीके हैं जिससे ज़्यादातर वाइल्ड लाइफ फोटोग्राफर्स का इनकम रहता है. और कितना इनकम होता है, इसका कोई सेट फॉर्मैट या कोई कन्फर्म्ड नंबर नहीं है. आप जितना काम करेंगे आप उतना इनकम जनरेट कर सकते हैं, जितना आप अपने आप को एक्सपैंड करेंगे उतना आप इनकम जनरेट कर सकते हैं. तो देर इज नो स्पेसिफिक इनकम, देर इज नो सैलरी एज सच, अंटिल एंड अनलेस ऑफ कोर्स आपको कोई जॉब दे रहा है वाइल्ड लाइफ फोटोग्राफी का, या आपको कोई एक पर्टिकुलर असाइनमेंट दे रहा है, जो कि ऑफ कोर्स इंडिया में बहुत कम होता है, बिकॉज अगेन डिमांड नहीं है. So another very frequent question is, how did you get yourself out there as a photographer? How did you get noticed? Frankly, initially it was the idea was not to pursue this as seriously. I was doing my street photography. I was preparing for my law entrance. I was, I think, in the second year of my graduation. And after a while, I realized that flying birds used to capture my attention. So I started practicing on those. I attended a workshop. And finally, I started showcasing my work, posted my work on Instagram, on Facebook, started being regular with that, started learning Lightroom, started learning Photoshop, paid some attention to all these softwares. After practicing those, I used to kind of post like very regularly, thought of showcasing my work everywhere, made account on a couple of more social media platforms, did that, created a social media presence, and so on and so forth. People started noticing the work, brands started noticing the work, different famous channels started noticing the work, and from there I started getting a few assignments. Now, if you're asking this for yourself, then just take a note of this suggestion that it's a very slow process. There's no shortcut to get noticed on social media. You have to be regular with your work. You have to post regularly. You have to be, of course, you have to maintain the quality. You have to maintain the kind of photographs that you're giving your followers out there. So that is there. Just do it. Give it a while. Be regular. Be equally passionate every time, and you will reach the destination. Do you face issue of dust on sensor in mirrorless bodies more often than a DSLR? Of course, that is the issue. When I was using a DSLR, I remember I hardly used to send it for cleaning. I think once every year was enough, and I used a DSLR for 5 years, 6 years, and never faced that issue. But with the mirrorless, on my last trip to Corbett, I faced a major issue. I had 4 camera bodies, and all of them were, the sensor of all of them were dirty. So I had to research on cleaning about the sensor, and from that day onwards, I decided to get my cameras cleaned like once every 2 trips. So that is there. And before leaving, I check my sensor also before leaving from Delhi. So that is there. And I would recommend that carry a camera cleaning kit, carry a sensor cleaning kit if you're using mirrorless, because that issue might come and then you will be disheartened in the field. So it's always good to carry the cleaning. What is life like for you as a constant traveler? So first thing, I'm not a constant traveler. Yes, I relatively do more trips, but I also practice law. So I'm not a constant traveler. I travel maybe once every 2 months, or and if I can actually pull out some dates, and if there are some long weekends, then maybe once every month or sometimes twice every month. But it's not that frequent. It's once in a blue moon. However, talking about life as a traveler, it's pretty good. It's something that I always wanted to do. I mean, since childhood, I think my parents were avid travelers, and we used to go on trips very regularly. During my school times also, whenever I used to get a holiday or a long weekend, me and my parents used to go out for a short trip, a short weekend anywhere nearby Delhi, or depending on how many holidays we could manage. For me, I always have a bag ready with all those clothes that I use in the jungle. I come back, I just get those washed, and then they're again in the bag, and that bag is always there in my library, always packed and always ready to go. So that is there. My gears are always ready, and that is something that actually gives me adds a lot of excitement in life. I absolutely love it. And when you come back from a trip and you know that there is a next trip planned, it is like it's a weird satisfaction. So that is there, and I absolutely love it. What is your relationship with Sudhir Shivaram? Well, with Sudhir sir, he's a mentor, he's a guide, he's a good friend, a very good friend. He's somebody who I've been looking up to since my day one. He's somebody who has actually handholded me in my entire journey in wildlife photography. He's someone who I actually look up to all the time, somebody I can actually call anytime, and he's always there to help. A very nice person, actually among the sweetest people I've met till date, and a very, very good teacher. So I really cherish the equation that we share. And if you're watching this, thank you so much, sir, for being there. Another very common question: what camera and lens do you prefer? What camera and lens you use? I'm using A9 Mark II most frequently. A9 Mark II is mounted on a 400 2.8. Now this guy is 20 fps, no blackouts between the frames. I am absolutely loving my experience with A9 Mark II, especially the tracking feature. It comes really, really handy in wildlife, especially in birds. And the lens that I'm using is 400 2.8 G Master. this guy is my favorite. Amazing results, amazing picture quality. I mean, something I cannot put in words. And 2.8 is just remarkable. If you ask me that which is the only, if there is one lens that I can carry in the field, then this guy will be the answer. I absolutely love my 400 2.8. One of the best lenses. Which is the best camera and lens for wildlife photography? I want to buy new and join your workshop. Something that I've been asked constantly in these years. And let me tell you, there is no best lens, there is no best camera. I have made a video on this. Here is the link if you want to check it. Frankly, best depends on what you like, best depends on what you shoot, best depends on what is your budget. I can't give you an answer for that, but I can of course tell you that how you can reach the best for yourself. Shortlist a couple of camera bodies and lenses that fall in your budget. Find out find out the features that they have and just encircle those features that you need in your camera, you need in your lens. And once you have a couple of shortlisted camera bodies and lenses, rent those, use those and invest the one which you like. So that is how you find the best for you. I can give you a couple of model names, but you might not like them because again, it really depends on the person who's shooting it. It really depends on the genre, budget. There are a lot of factors. So you find the best for you and let me know. Which lens will you suggest with Canon 90D? See, frankly, whenever you ask for a lens suggestion, it's very important that you give a budget cap on that because I can suggest you innumerable lenses. And I think a number of the lenses initially when we are starting are out of our budget. So if I talk about something that you can use as a beginner, then you can definitely go for 100, 400. Besides that, you can maybe try invest in third party lenses like Tamron 150-600 G2 or maybe a Sigma 150-600. But of course, a 70-200 2.8 also. But before you decide, before you purchase any of these lenses, one thing that I would really recommend you is that rent those lenses, try those lenses, compare the results of those lenses and invest in the lens which you think is appropriate for you. Because I can suggest you, I can give you a couple of model numbers, but in the end, it's you who will have to use it. It's your hard-earned money that will go in that lens. So initially, in the end, when we don't get the results, we end up blaming the gear that we have. So always use it before you buy it. And that is the suggestion that I can give to you. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining me. And I've answered a few questions. Don't be disheartened if yours was not taken because I will be coming out with part two soon, maybe in the next couple of days. And if you have any other topics on which you would want me to make a video or discuss, then let me know in the comment section below and I will definitely take a note of that. Bye-bye, thank you and have a nice day.